lovely to see you.
Anyway, I want to welcome you in the palace jail of my grandfather. As you know, Sultan Murad was captive here during 28 years. Not only he, but his family. My grandmother came here as a captive. She was 6 years old. So it's very emotional for me to be here. When I am at the moment having a very nice room in this hotel, and I have a view on the palace. And when I look at it and I think how lucky I am, because he was 28 years there, he died there. And you would say, well, after all, it's not so bad, it's a palace, it's a beautiful palace. But one has to know what it was. I was told by my old aunts when I was very young, some of my aunts were still living and had lived there, or their mother had lived there. And I know through them that it was, first, they could not go out at all for 28 years or more. Nobody could come and see them. The windows on the street side were completely walled. And on the Bosphorus, the boat had could not go near the palace. They had to go on the other side. And also, when somebody, it was very, very cold. There was no heating, nothing. And when somebody was sick, one had to ask the permission of the Sultan, Abdul Hamid, so that a doctor could come in. And the Sultan had many things to do, and he was not there, so some people could die because no doctor was coming. So it was not such a pleasant stay. And my poor great-grandfather, Sultan Murad, he was deposed because he had a fit of mental problem. He had a shock when his uncle, Sultan Abdulaziz, was killed. One said he suicided, he did not suicide, it seemed he was killed. And so Sultan Murad was a young man at that time. For him, it was a big shock. And he had a mental problem at that time. But a doctor came from Austria, the biggest specialist, and he said, after 3 months, I can cure him, there is no problem. He needs rest and an easy life, and etc. But one did not leave him the time. And I suppose for political reason, one put Sultan Abdul Hamid, who was a very, very strong political man. Sultan Murad was an artist. He was very sensitive. He was composing music. You can even listen to this music. There is a very good Emre Arajj who has put Sultan Murad music, which was made for piano. He has put it as orchestra, and it's very beautiful. It's like, it's very easy. It's 19th century music, a little like Strauss music. And he was very sad, of course, because he was a captive in this place. But he was composing very happy and gay music, merry music, so that his daughters, the three young sultans, could dance. And I think it's very moving that this man had lost everything and was really very sad, was composing merry music for his daughter to dance. So the first time I came here, the first time I saw it, it was in ruins, total ruins. There was this football ground. But then I came here when it had been rebuilt, and I must say, from the outside architecture, absolutely wonderful. And I was just visiting, but I was allowed to swim in this beautiful swimming pool. And I remember I was in the swimming pool, I was alone, because it was the first day, I think. I was alone, and I was looking at the palace, and I was crying, because I was thinking of my family who had been captive there, and I was having a good time in the swimming pool, so it was very moving, very emotional. So, what to tell you about the family? I'm asked often, how I feel. My family has been exiled, as you know. Oh, by the way, I wanted to tell you also that there has been many stories said, which of course are wrong, are false. For instance, I can tell you, because I always heard from my family, that everybody was praying for the victory of Mustafa Kemal, which is normal, because after all, the family was praying for the freedom of the country and for the victory of Mustafa Kemal. Obviously, they did not... Obviously, they did not know they would be exiled, that they could not guess. Especially also the young sultans were looking at Mustafa Kemal. You may know maybe that Mustafa Kemal asked for the hand of Sabia Sultan. I have known Sabia Sultan. She was the daughter of Sultan Vahid-e-Din. I've known her, she was an old lady. And I know as a fact, as you know, there was competition between Enver Pasha and Mustafa Kemal. They did not like each other. Enver Pasha had married a sultan, the daughter of Sultan Reshat. So Mustafa Kemal felt that he could also marry a sultan, which was normal because the princes were given to the pasha and to the vizier. And so he asked for the hand of Sabia Sultan. He could have married her, but the sultan was told that Mustafa Kemal liked to drink a lot and also womanizing. So he felt, no, not for my daughter. He's a great pasha, he's a great man, but I prefer. And we all are sorry for it, because we think if he had married Sabia Sultan, maybe we would not have been exiled. But anyway, that's story. When I came here for the first time, it was, of course, very, for me, a great thing. I came, I was already 26, and I was going into the bazaar in Capalu Church, and I was seeing in the shopkeepers showing me Torah, and they were telling me very proudly, you know, here we had sultans, and I said yes. And also, and I was feeling a little sad, because of course I was like, everybody thought I was a French tourist. I could not speak Turkish, because by the way, I speak Turkish very, very little, because my mother died in Paris, I was 1 year old. So I was brought up by French people, Swiss and French, and I never had the possibility to learn Turkish. I learned a little, but very little. So I was feeling a little sad, because I was feeling this country, which I felt was my country, I was feeling I was like a tourist. Until the time I went to Tehran, to Topkapi. And there was a guy there, and there were a group of people, and I was touching a chair, I was touching a piano where I thought a grandmother of mine has been playing maybe or something. And the guy said, you can't touch, you have no right to touch. So of course I was feeling bad. Then we arrive in the gallery of portraits, and there he says something about the sultans, he says something about Sultan Murad, and I said, no, it's not this, it's that. And he said, how do you know? I said, well, I'm his granddaughter. So the old guy came to me and kissed my hand, and called the other guy who came and kissed my hand, and then I felt I had found Turkey again, had been adopted. And that was a great, great time for me. After that, I've come many times. How to tell you, people have always been very nice to me. I don't feel, and you know, to me, I always say Turkey has two legs, because I was asked often. Turkey has two legs, and they need these two legs, the Ottoman leg and the Kemalist leg. And because people who don't have a past, or who don't know their past, who have no roots, it's very bad psychologically. One has to know, you know, the French, if they did not know their big, their story with all the kings, they would be lost. And I think it's good for the Turks now, they remember that they had a very big story. I mean, 6 centuries of empire with the same family. But of course, I mean, I think also, when I'm asked, I say, I think Mustafa Kemal could not do otherwise. Because, of course, all the people who did not like him were looking and going to the caliph. And for him, he had, I suppose, to send the caliph away so that the opposition would not go around with the caliph. And in the same time, I mean, for the women, of course, for us women, Mustafa Kemal did a lot. It had begun before. One must say that at the time, after the Tanzimat, the beginning of the 20th century, around 1900, something like that, or even before, there were feminist groups. There were newspapers of a magazine of women. So there was a beginning of liberation of the women, if one can say. But of course, it was prevented also by a few people like Sherul Islam, and some people were putting barriers to that. And with Mustafa Kemal, of course, it was much, much easier. He could do what he wanted. So to me, I think there is no problem feeling an Ottoman and feeling a Turkish citizen. I think, in fact, and I like Turkey because I think it's such a lively country with a youth very, very enterprising, very lively youth. It's very different from Europe, where people are quite old. And I think Turkey, with all its problems, has a huge human capital. And this is the main wealth of Turkey, I feel. So I'm thinking that maybe I'm going to settle in Istanbul and try to research for a new book. By the way, I have an idea of a new book. I found out that one lady of the family, very near to Sultan Murad, was, during the year 20, she was in contact with a group, a Kemalist group in Istanbul, and she was giving them information which were sent to Mustafa Kemal to help the freedom, independence freedom. So you see, the family was not totally against, on the contrary. So if there is any question, no, I suppose no. So I finished before time. I promised I would finish in time, so it's before time.
Thank you.